Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the newest series. I'll talk about that issue later. Fallout 4. I'm starting up this series in lieu of Elder Scrolls Skyrim. I've gotten some feedback. People would rather see Fallout 4. So here it is. As per usual, just like Skyrim was, I mean, this isn't as heavily modded. I have a few mods, mostly fixing things. Little adjustments here and there, extra colors in the world, couple little different things, a little bit of weapon rebalancing, stuff like that. We'll kind of see things as they go along. For those of you that are familiar with this game, you'll probably see the differences. For those of you that are not, just ignore them and go with it. So yeah, this video is going to be a long one. I'm going to play all the way through what would be considered the intro, which is quite lengthy. So, without further ado, let's get this new game going. Also, the audio issue is an issue I've always had. It happens from time to time, and I don't know how to fix it yet. I'll be looking into that as the series progresses. What was that? Oh, sorry, everybody. That was my headphone cable deciding to just freak out on my mic stand. Cool. Because you get the little... Because everybody loves hearing that, right? Right. Bethesda Game Studios presents... As if you couldn't read it yourself. Fallout 4. Bam, bam, bam! Like, who wants it to be like an old murder mystery? Okay.
War. War never changes. In the year 1945, my great-great-grandfather, serving in the army, wondered when he'd get to go home to his wife and the son he'd never seen. He got his wish when the U.S. ended World War II by dropping atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The world awaited Armageddon. Instead, something miraculous happened. We began to use atomic energy not as a weapon, but as a nearly limitless source of power. People enjoyed luxuries once thought the realm of science fiction. Domestic robots, fusion-powered cars, portable computers. But then, in the 21st century, people awoke from the American dream. Years of consumption led to shortages of every major resource. The entire world unraveled. Peace became a distant memory. It is now the year 2077. We stand on the brink of total war. And I am afraid. For myself. For my wife. For my infant son. Because if my time in the army taught me one thing, it's that war never changes. War never changes.
You're gonna knock him dead at the Veterans Hall tonight, hon.
You think?
Absolutely. Now get ready and stop hogging the mirror.
Right.
So, first thing I gotta say is all this technology and they can't find a way to keep your mirror from fogging up. Really? Like, you hear him wipe it down. Like, come on. So, build a character. Something that bothers me a little bit. I mean, I'm gonna be a little nitpicky. about the game, I guess, just because it's just like, come on, they could have done better. I understand that it's designed to play as a male protagonist. And, like, the whole intro is, you know, the man and blah, 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 blah. But I think they should make it where...
My turn, big guy.
You could choose your character beforehand, and then the story would go accordingly. I am going to play as a female. Because why not? Come on, why not? Also, I have not played as a female yet. I have not made... Wow, okay. One of the mods you guys will notice is an eye mod, and apparently... Because I just picked them at random. Apparently one of them is those. So that's brilliant. Actually, I really like that. Da-da-da-ba. I'm not going to do a whole lot. In fact, I might not actually do anything. I mean, it's a preset, and everybody's just like, eh, preset. It's usually actually how I am. Boop. Oh yeah, there's makeup. I haven't done that. I hope this is going to be either fantastic or really awful. Because this is another thing that I've always kind of wondered about. Like, I could understand having makeup in this era, but how do you keep your makeup up later? Like, it just doesn't make sense. Yeah, I'm going to completely leave this. I mean, I could have removed, I guess. My first character that I made for this, because I have played this a little bit. I really have not played much. I've been intentionally not playing much to play for this Let's Play. So a vast majority of this Let's Play is actually going to be blind. I'm familiar with the Fallout games and stuff like that, so I have an idea of what it'll be kind of like. But I don't know the story. I've avoided as many spoilers as I possibly can. So hopefully, you know, this will be something different. But the first character I made was the man over there. Not the man. I didn't make the man. Wow, that sounded weird. So I played as the male protagonist. And he had scars and he looked all crazy. And it was kind of like, speaking of crazy, like, what is that about? Like, I'm really, like, I understand they put that in there, but it's just like, really? No, I guess I'm just going to leave her good. I did mean to change her hair. Boop. No. Boop. Boop. There we go. I hope there's good ones. I haven't looked through the female hairstyles. It's surprisingly, there's not that many mods out there for certain things like hair. And it's going to be covered most of the time anyway, so I don't... Oh, man. So I don't know why I'm really bothering. Like, that's kind of one of the things is, like, I added the eye mod so eyes would look better. Because, I mean, come on. Like, they should. Because, like, you guys will see, for those of you that aren't familiar with this, you actually get to see a lot of your actual characters. Both NPCs and your actual character. She is so excited. Okay. A lot of these are pretty classic. Making a crazy morning here. That looks good.
Wait. Did you go to the hairdresser yesterday?
Oh yeah, that's right. As you change things, they make witty little, or what they think are witty little comments that I'm not a very big fan of.
I have the best hairdresser, I swear.
See? Yeah, they think they're... Oh, that's not quite what I wanted. Okay, that's not the color I thought I was changing. Can we get just the eyebrows? That'd be great. That's another reason. Like, a lot of people aren't really big fans of... Come on.
You look lovely.
Aren't a really big fan of this way of editing the faces. It's kind of weird. I swear I'm not going to I'm not going to spend a lot of time.
Not bad at all.
Seriously? Like, I'm not even really doing anything. Okay, why can't... Or did it already change and it just doesn't look like it? Oh yeah, her eyes already did change. You know, the more I look at her, the more I'm just like, no, this is terrible. What am I thinking? Why would I ever do this? Ah, but I like white hair. It's cool. Go super cliche. Oh god, that's the other thing I don't like. Is like anytime, like if you're holding the mouse and making them look and stuff. What is that? Cool brown apparently equals purple. Awesome. Auburn. Yeah, I like that.
New hair color.
Good song. Yeah, I think we're just gonna pretty much keep things. I mean, like, also, I don't like her outfit at all, which I think is hilarious. Okay, that's... Their proportions are weird. Except, and I think we are just going to call that good. I'm not going to go with anything super fancy. Do I not get it? Did I miss a spot about naming my character? Also, you guys will see a bunch of radio signals are being found. I have a mod that adds radio because I'm sick and tired of hearing the same stuff over and over.
Hey, hun.
I'm hurrying up. Don't worry. Just getting ready. I'll just be a minute. Why don't you see if breakfast is ready? I'm hurrying up, don't worry.
Okay, there's all those. Yeah, that's a dandy of a mirror there. So, character. For those of you that are wondering, I am playing this in Ultra for my settings. I haven't had any issues. We're gonna kinda see how this recording goes. Because the recording doesn't seem to be the best.
Another fine product of General Atomics International.
Also, the whole voiced over main characters is weird.
Let Codsworth take care of it.
Yeah, speaking of Codsworth. Eh, we'll just go see him.
Ah, good morning, Mom. Your coffee. 173.5 degree Fahrenheit. Brewed to perfection. And today's newspaper just delivered.
Oh, it's over there, because...
Grognak the Barbarian and the Jungle of the Bat Babies.
Great comics right there. Let's see, yep, and that triggers him.
More of the same.
Well, maybe not all of us know what that is. You think they'd make a comment? Aww. I have a patio set. Okay.
Now, sounds like someone made a sticky. I shall attend to young Sean.
I know we were nervous at first, but I'm glad we got Codsworth.
New Coca-Cola. Ice cold. Looks like the milk got delivered. Saddle up Salisbury steak. Rated A+. How can someone so small drink so much?
They really had a lot of fun making this and being like, okay, we're gonna make everything give you an option to talk about it. Okay, not everything, but okay.
It's a little early to be drinking.
Fine.
That salesman again. I don't know why he keeps bothering you.
Okay, I should go take care of this. Do-do-do-do. Let's go see the creeper outside the door. Boop.
Good morning. Vault-Tec calling.
Vault-Tec? Remind me again.
Why, we're about you, ma'am. And helping secure your future. You see, Vault-Tec is the foremost builder of state-of-the-art underground fallout shelters. Vaults, if you will. Luxury accommodations where you can wait out the horrors of nuclear devastation. You can't begin to know how happy I am to finally speak with you. I've been trying for days. It's a matter of utmost urgency, I assure you.
I'm here now.
So you are. So you are. Now, I know you're a busy woman, so I won't take up much of your time. Time being, a precious commodity. I'm here today to tell you that because of your family's service to our country, you have been pre-selected for entrance into the local vault. Vault 111.
I've always wanted to be an absolute dick back to a lot of characters, and I'm really tempted on doing it for this playthrough to find out what it is. You know what? I'm kind of busy.
Look, I'm really busy.
Oh, of course, of course. This won't take but a moment. It's just a matter of verifying some information. Need to make sure you're cleared for entrance in the unforeseen event of, total atomic annihilation.
You know, that happens all the time. And I will always, 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 I have not done this yet, I will always take a sarcastic reply.
The apocalypse? Well, hell, sign me up.
That's the spirit. Now, let's see.
Figure I might as well also, you know, I might as well pick the sarcastic responses, because for those of you that are familiar, I might be a little tiny bit sarcastic. Just sometimes. I know this is a really, really awkward build, but we're just gonna see how it goes from here. I love that they make little different sounds. So, in most of the previous games... Oh man! For those of you wondering, that was me knocking my water bottle over. So, in the previous games, it's always been a bit of a thing that you work on your special, you know, and you'd have to set it up a certain way. Your character would actually be very limited in the original games by what you could do. In this game, it's a little bit of the same way. You very much, as I have come to realize... The two things that you really, really want are intelligence and charisma. Specifically intelligence, and I'm actually going to bring my charisma down a little bit. Probably to throw it in endurance so I can have a little extra health. Previously, I've always been a perception, intelligence, agility character. And oddly enough, it seems like the whole... Like, I don't have much use for perception in this. Because it has to do with your environmental awareness, sixth sense, you know, weapon accuracy, and VATS. I rarely use VATS. I'll use VATS on small, fast enemies, like bloat flies, which we encounter relatively often. Annoying things like that. Every once in a while, I'll do it just for the critical system that they have built into VATS now. But it's just kind of one of those things. In fact, I'm actually going to bring that down another one. Put it in luck. Luck has... Like it says, the measure of your general good fortune. There are some really fantastic things that can happen when your luck's high enough. And some really awful things that can happen if your luck isn't high enough. So this is the kind of build I'm going to go for. There's some nice things I would love to do with charisma if I can, you know, up it a little bit more. Stuff like that. We are going to find some things early on in game that are going to boost a couple of these, which is going to be awesome. But now... Here is the issue. What on earth do we name our character? There's a name I've always wanted to put in, but I don't know how they would need to spell it, because part of... I don't know if that's actually how they would want to spell that, but close enough. I don't care. That's what it's going to be. So, Rosalind. And In this game, it's kind of weird, because sometimes if you put in the right name, other characters will call you by name, which, as I previously put my own name in, was a relatively freaky surprise.
Wonderful. That's everything. Just gonna walk this over to the vault. Congratulations on being prepared for the future.
The future.
Thanks again.
Hey, it's peace of mind. That's worth a little paperwork, right?
For you and Sean, no price is too high.
Good answer.
I have my moments.
Sean has been changed, but he absolutely refuses to calm down.
Or you could just shove me away. That's great.
Hey, Codsworth.
Go ahead, honey.
No, I'm just gonna walk away from him. No.
A little motherly love to quiet the nerves.
My boy isn't giving his mother any trouble, is he? Hey, I fixed that mobile on his crib.
And he magically appears.
Give it a spin.
Whoop.
That's my boy. On his best behavior, just like his dad. Well, most of the time, anyway. Listen, after breakfast, I was thinking we could head to the park for a bit. Weather should hold up.
Sarcastic!
Oh, right. The park. With you. Because I want to get pregnant again.
Sir?
Oh!
Come and see this!
Oh. Oh, these sarcastic comments are going to be fantastic.
I wonder what Sean will grow up to be.
I like how they keep the door closed. It's like he could have at least opened the door. No.
Followed by flashes, blinding flashes, sounds of explosions. We're trying to get confirmation.
Wait,
we seem to
what?
Have lost contact with
what
our
affiliate
stations.
Oh, no.
We do have coming in. That's confirmed reports. I repeat, confirmed reports of nuclear detonations in New York and Pennsylvania. My God.
Oh my God. We need to get to the vault. Now!
I like how the house just, like, knows, like, that your door needs to be opened.
Evacuate to Vault 111 immediately.
I should probably go. As some people have found out, and as a YouTuber I follow found out the hard way, if you hang around, bad things happen. Oh, wait, I can sprint. Not over the bridge. Whee! Because, you know, every single day I can just jump over that, you know. Hey, it's like now. Look who it is.
I'm reporting this!
God, we're gonna die!
We need to get in. We're on the list.
Infant. Adult male. Adult female. Okay, go ahead.
Can I just steal your guys' stuff? That'd be great.
Come on!
What's gonna happen to all those people outside the
gate?
We're
doing everything we can. Now keep moving.
Vertibird. Wait, can I get crushed by the vertibird? No, it goes through my head. That's sad. But it's so pretty.
He's fine. We're gonna be okay.
He's just not moving or crying or anything.
Oh my God!
And then it happened.
Hold on!
And there's the wave. Ba-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da.
And an orderly
a sign.
No need to worry, folks. We'll get everyone situated in your new home. Vault 111. A better future underground.
So we just...
Yes, up the stairs.
I can't believe it. If we left a minute later...
No,
we'd
no.
All be...
Don't get caught up thinking about that. You're safe now. Everyone, just
hey.
Head up these stairs and through
oh
the door
God.
There.
creepy eyes. Okay, I suppose I should finally get off the elevator, huh? Boop. Creepy.
Please, head creepy. Up the stairs. Got a lot to do to get you oriented.
Excuse me.
We just need a minute.
That's sad. Also, if you guys haven't noticed. Yes, I did notice that.
Please proceed in an orderly fashion.
This game goes pretty crazy with lighting effects.
Take a vault
so.
And head just down this way.
Female.
Excuse me.
Hello there. Once we seal the vault, we'll all be getting to know each other a lot more, I'm sure.
Okay.
Male and infant. Good.
One vault seal.
Over there.
The hell?
Just okay. Step over to the table.
Each of you take one of these. Your brand new vault suits. It's down
Thanks.
The hallway right there.
What now?
Just follow the doctor here. He'll show you where to go.
All right, you three. Follow me.
See?
Oh, geez.
This is our new home.
Oh, you're gonna love it here. This is one of our most advanced facilities. Not that the others aren't great, mind you. It's gone. Our home. Everything we had.
Ma'am? My mother and father down in D.C.
How long do you think we'll be down here?
Oh, we'll be going over all that in orientation. Just a few medical items we have to get through first.
Every step of the way, you'll thrive here.
It's a good fit, don't you think?
Just checking everyone off the list.
It's designed to be fashionable as well as comfortable.
Prepared for the future, right?
Such a lovely family you have. I hope you'll see this as your new home.
Just step in here and put your vault suit on.
It'll be okay.
I'm with you, kid.
Mommy's right here.
I'm with you, kid.
Who's my little guy, huh? I'm not going far. I'll just be over there.
There she is, see? Mommy's not going far.
All set? Just step inside and put on your vault suit.
What if I don't? Because this is sketchy, dude. Like, why is everything covered in frost? I can't punch anybody, otherwise I think I'd probably try to punch the doctor just for fun. Magically in the outfit.
The pod will decontaminate and depressurize you before we head deeper in the vault. Just relax.
Time for a whole new life.
Resident secure. Occupant vitals normal. Procedure complete. In 5, 4, 3.
Something's hinky. Exactly. We thought we knew how vaults worked.
This is the one. Here.
Open it.
Wait, why is she wearing a full suit and he isn't? Like, she's got, like, a hazmat on. And he's just like, I don't care.
Are we okay?
Almost. Everything's gonna be fine.
Mysterious figure. So, that happened. Unfortunately. But, you know, hey, there's the plot. In a good old Fallout sort of way. They say talk on there.
I'll find who did this. And I'll get Sean back. I promise.
And outfit.
Oh, God. Why would Vault-Tec do this? I can't be the only one left. Hello? Anyone?
You guys will see me picking up stuff like crazy in this game. You little bastards. Security terminal. Oops, sorry, hit my mic stand again. Yeah, there's really nothing great in here. I have no holotapes. Of course I don't. Oh, what was that? Oh, desk. Coffee cup. Anything? Nothing? Really? Nothing? Nothing? So many doors. Ah, there's the bugger. Nah, get it. Yeah, it was bad, I know, I'm sorry. Boop! Sneak attack!
Giant roaches? What the hell?
Radiation does that. You know, because totally happens in every story ever. Really? There's absolutely, I suppose, people would have left with just about everything, except coffee cups, apparently. Everybody just doesn't want their coffee cup. Or a toaster. Or a hot plate. That hot plate is gonna come in handy. Beer bottle. Ooh, bobby pin. Recreational terminal. Yes. We are going to not even play the tape. We're not gonna do any of it. We're just gonna grab the tape and go. We'll see why later. Because there's a lot of that in this game. Let's run down there, right? Totally great idea. And now we get to fight some more red roaches. Boop.
Boop. What happened here? Where is everyone?
You know, I swear by this point I already had a weapon. Whatever. I'll get one when I get one. Oh, really? Really? Again, take everything. Ah, here we go. And skeleton.
Is this all that's left?
Oh, yeah. This entry is actually a little bit important. It's not like crazy important or anything like that, but oops. Do need that. Like, I know there's a reason. Yay! So, reason why that's a little bit important. There's the Cryolator. I am absolutely, of course, because what fun would it be in the beginning of the game if you could immediately get a weapon of that type.
Nice. Coming back later for you.
Good plan. Because I totally need another gun. They should totally allow dual wielding in this game. That'd be great. Oh, hey. And those high-tech mirrors. Oh, okay. That's nice. Oh, there's a little bit of audio problems. Oh. Oh. I like how it says preserved cigarettes. It's like, yeah, is there going to be any other kind? I mean, really. Oh, yes. Oops. Can't play. Really? And at that point, I'm just wasting ammo. Which is a very precious commodity in this one. Oh, hi. Oop. Oop. I spend a lot of time sneaking. It's mostly just because I move slower. Avoid bright light. Oh, yeah, that's talking about remaining undetected.
Is anyone alive? Did anyone get out?
And where are they just really? Did anybody else even see that? Did it pop out? Oh, yeah, it must have popped out from under there. I'm like, what the crap? And best part. Did him a lot of good. Obviously. I love how the screen just, like, magically cleans itself. 64K of RAM! Yeah! And our Pip-Boy. Radio. We'll get into all that more later. Just the stuff we have. An overview of our character. Oh yes, the ring gives a boost to charisma. That's what it was. I'm like, why? Yes. And let's get out of here. As I literally step on this skeleton, apparently. I also love how my character just magically knew how to do that. Let's get into a good position. But I don't want to stand back. Yeah, there we go. Like I said, they like their lighting effects. If it isn't obvious, I don't really care for playing in third person. Also, super loud music is super loud. I don't know if it's as loud for you guys, but it's extremely loud for me. That's mostly okay. Okay, I know I missed stuff back here, because I remember for a fact there were melee weapons I got a hold of. I'll probably go back for those another time. I'm actually going to switch up these a little bit. I'm actually going to bring that charisma point down and put it in something else. I just haven't decided what yet. I'm thinking about putting it in strength because it allows us to carry more, which means I'm not going to have to jump back and forth and ditch stuff off, which it really doesn't take very long. It's fast travel here, fast travel back. No big deal. Oh, crap. Strength does affect some other perks that I like getting. Oh, wow, I hate to do this. And yet again, everything turns out pretty balanced, except intelligence, because that needs to be there. Not gonna change appearance, and let's get out of this hellhole.
Enjoy your return to the surface, and thank you for choosing Vault Deck.
I have a feeling we're probably not going to really enjoy our trip back to the surface. Wow, this is turning into a long episode. This is a long intro. I think I am actually going to... I was going to go a little bit farther with it, but I think I am going to actually cut it here right when we get out of the vault. Just so you guys don't have to sit through quite so much. And cliche Fallout exiting a vault effects happen. Bright light, blurry vision. So this is our view of what used to be where we lived. All those wonderful autumnal colors and trees are obviously quite different. So, next time, we're gonna start scavenging around, see what we can get our hands on. As you can imagine, we don't really have much to start with. So the more, oops, there we go. The more we can get, the better. We do already have a handful of junk items, but we'll be using those as soon as possible. So, keep posted about this series. I want to get it out in a relatively reasonable time. I'd like to put out a lot of this because I really want to play this game. And I don't want to keep waiting. I do only record on Mondays and Tuesdays, usually multiple episodes. So don't expect from episode to episode for you guys to give me a hint and I immediately get it. There's always some level of pre-recording going on. So, something for me to keep in mind, as I learned in the Skyrim series, is lighting is key. There's going to be a lot of dark moments in this game. When I can, I'm going to try to turn on my Vault Boy flashlight light thing. Oops, that is not the right key. So, we'll try to do that. And if there's anything you guys would like to see specifically, let me know. I do have my own little plan of what I'm going to do for the opening. I do have a question, though. Would you guys like to see, for those that aren't familiar with the series, you'll see this when we get to it in the next episode, but you have the ability to build settlements and rebuild places, you know, build on, you know, custom homes, all this sorts of stuff. Now, I have a mod that allows me to get rid of more things than usual. I will actually be able to get rid of, like, these little piles of leaves and the junk that's laying around. Not over here. Not over here, but back over in the town in Sanctuary. So, do you guys want to see me work on that stuff? Obviously, some of it I'm going to do on camera because it's, like, quest-related and stuff like that. But, like, I've never really worked on it in my games. And it can be pretty tedious, I know. So let me know if you guys would like to see it. But I'm supposing that'll be a couple episodes away when I get really into it. But from here, we can actually see several places that we're going to start going to. Main part here, like I said, is Sanctuary. This little A-shaped thing is a very important location for us. We'll be heading this way eventually, and you can kind of see some buildings off in the distance. I did find out there's some cool stuff back around this way, but I'll probably die if I go there. So, into Sanctuary for the next... Wow, good thing I'm stopping this recording right now. Can't even talk. The next episode, headed into Sanctuary. Thank you for watching, and stay tuned for the next episode.